Namaste, Hamastu, Ashe, Hatip, Hotip, Shalom, Salam, all the many ways there are to say the word peace. Welcome back, everyone, to our latest episode and our latest transmission of Introduction into Studying with the Trefoil Social Club. Everyone who has watched the previous episode and transmission know that we start every video off with a little music, so let's get to it, shall we? We think that's enough. We're going to try to keep it short so they don't, you know, block the video due to copyright infringement like they've been doing. So everyone who has studied with us before know that we don't have a set topic. We just finna roll with it. If y'all ready, let's get started. There's been a gentleman that's been on my mind, right, who I've been following for several years. I think, if I'm not mistaken, I think he's passed away. Rest in peace, his soul. But I want to introduce you all to someone. Okay, yeah, this is him. Ted. Let's talk about old Ted Gunderson for a moment here, okay? Theodore L. Gunderson short TED, was an American Federal Bureau of Investigation special agent in charge, okay? So he didn't just work for the FBI, he was in charge and head of the LA FBI, right? According to his son, he worked the case of Marilyn Monroe and the John F. Kennedy cases now. He was the author of the best-selling book, How to Locate Anyone, Anywhere Without Leaving Home. See, there's one thing we want y'all to know about us blatantly, is that we're not going to waste your time. We are not here. There is so much crap and buffoonery and tomcoonery going on. We are not trying to waste anybody's time. So anytime we got a video, we got something for you. Something worth checking out. Something worth taking time out of your day to research and or study. Okay? So Ted Gunderson was head of the FBI in LA. Okay? Head of the FBI. I thought I'd turn my phone on Do Not Disturb. Head of the FBI in L.A., born November 7th, 1928 in Colorado Springs, died July 31st, 2011, Memphis, Tennessee. All right. This man had a book called How to Locate Anyone, Anywhere Without Leaving Home, and he authored this book in 1989. Listen, y'all. Y'all listening? That was 31 years ago. The head of the FBI in LA in 89 released a book, How to Locate Anyone, Anywhere Without Leaving the House. And guess what? I believe him. Why? Because he the head of the FBI, was the head of the FBI. So if anybody would know how to locate anyone anywhere without leaving your house, let's take a wild guess as to who might have been able to figure that out, right? Then he released another book so he co-authored a book, right, before he passed, but this book wasn't released until 7 years after his passing, and it's called The 200-Year Plan. We highly suggest everyone who ever listens to this to not only research this man, Ted Gunderson, because he has audio lectures and video lectures all over the web, but we highly suggest y'all check out these two books, and I'm pretty sure because of the day and age that we in that you can find these books PDF somewhere. When we be like, check out these books, we ain't necessarily saying purchase them unless they're not available PDF for free anywhere. Then, of course, you have to purchase them. But we're telling you it is as much crap as we buy on a daily basis. Right. A $10 or $15 book shouldn't be that hard to afford unless you don't want it. But you make time for what you want. You delegate funds towards what it is that you want. So. And once you know better, you do better. You understand? So if you don't want to read, then don't bother. Really, if you're not interested in learning, there's a difference between thinking and learning. Okay? If you're not interested in learning, you shouldn't even be watching these videos. This is not the YouTube channel for you if you're not interested in learning. And if you may not be interested in learning about this, but you need to be interested in learning something. Okay? Let's look up old Ted. See what he got for us. Occupation: FBI senior special agent in charge, private investigator, speaker, author, conspiracy researcher. Titles that he acquired while in the FBI include Senior Special Agent in Charge, Special Agent in Charge. That was it. Let's go post-FBI, after he retired. After retiring from the FBI, Gunderson set up a private investigation firm, Ted L. Gunderson and Associates in Santa Monica. I think this is still a legitimate, ongoing business today that you all can employ their services. Okay? In 1980, he became a defense investigator for Green Beret doctor Jeffrey R. McDonald, who had been convicted of the 1970 murders of his pregnant wife and two daughters. Gunderson obtained affidavits from Helena Stockley confessing to her involvement in the murders, which she claimed had in actuality been perpetrated by a satanic cult of which she was a member. Let's take a step back, y'all, because this isn't anybody that we're just talking about. This isn't some random nobody, okay? This is the head of the FBI, okay? And the head of the FBI is saying that he obtained two affidavits from Helena Stockley confessing to her involvement in the murders, which she claimed had in actuality been perpetrated by a satanic cult of which she was a member. Okay. So one, first of all, this man is not very well liked. Let me go ahead and throw that out there right now. This isn't the guy you could joke around with him, but there's a time and a place for everything. But he was the guy who took his job very seriously and was very good at it. Not saying that he was a square or, he wasn't irking. He was just special agent in charge. What you think? You know what I mean? So by him investigating this satanic cult, okay, and started and becoming one of the first people in the U.S. to start speaking up about the satanic cults and their influence and their effect in the Americas, he didn't become a very, very well liked people, especially in L.A. and Hollywood. Okay. Let's go even further to see why nobody really liked him as much as they liked everybody else. He also investigated a child molestation trial in Manhattan Beach, California. In a 1995 conference in Dallas, Gunderson warned about the supposed proliferation of secret occultist groups and the danger posed by the New World Order. An alleged shadow government that will be controlling the United States government. Back up, okay? Let's just back up for a second. None of this sounds bizarre to anybody, right? These are the type of things that are talked about in everybody's day-to-day conspiracy theory conversations, right? But we're not talking about a conspiracy theory here because we're dealing with the head of the FBI, okay? Let's just keep on reiterating that you are dealing with the head of the FBI, which means if he's confident enough to be speaking about this type of stuff and be writing books about it and having lectures about it, then he must mean what he say. He must really mean it. He must really got some facts. Some actual facts and some evidence to back up and support these claims. You understand? Y'all know anything about the feds? Okay? In order for him to be head of the FBI, right? And to be talking about this, he must have some real facts and some real evidence to support just that. Okay? And he's saying that you have satanic cults going on. You have child molestation rings going on. And you got shadow governments going on. And he even quoted saying it all in combination. When you put all three of these and more into all in one, he referred to that as the New World Order, not one or the other. but the combination of all of the above. He also claimed that a slave auction in which children were sold by Saudi agents to men had been held in Las Vegas. I'm not surprised, me personally. Let's continue. That 4,000 ritual human sacrifices are performed in New York City every year. Wait a minute now. He making some large claims here. Do you understand? Some extremely large claims here, y'all. He just said that 4,000 ritual human sacrifices are performed in New York City every year. And that the 1995 bombing of the Alfred P. Murrah Federal Building in Oklahoma City was carried out by the U.S. government. This is the head of the FBI saying this, y'all. Like, this ain't... Okay, I'm gonna quit. I'm gonna cut it out. Gunderson believed that in the United States, there is a secret widespread network of groups who kidnap children and infants and subject them to ritual abuse and subsequent human sacrifice. And this is his life's work. This man, it say retired from the FBI, but we all know what that means. Okay? His life work was to bringing it to public attention, right? Of these satanic cults, these child molestation rings, these human sacrifice rings, right? And these shadow governments. He decided to make it his life's purpose to bring this forward. And guess what? People don't even remember his name. He worked the Marilyn Monroe case and the John F. Kennedy case. But do you know who he is? No, not until now. Man, let's go to the references. Former Memphis FBI chief Gunderson dies. Okay. Society of Former Special Agents of the FBI. The Dallas Division, office locations and special agents in charge. Jeffrey McDonald, time for truth. Around the nation, investigation reopened in doctor's murder case. Conspiracy theories and paranoia. Notes from a mind control conference. Former FBI chief Ted Gunderson says chemtrail death dumps must be stopped. Also, 9/11 was an inside job, says FBI special agent in charge, Ted Gunderson. Okay. Y'all better quit playing with this man. Satanism, myth and reality in a contemporary moral panic. Moral panics in the media. Reflections on Ted Gunderson. 993 World Trade Center and FBI setup. Come on, y'all. Y'all better quit playing with this man. We highly suggest everybody in here, man, take a look. Take a look up. Look up this man. Look up his works. Look up his life's work. Okay? That's only if you're interested. Other than that, so he passed away from bladder cancer. Before we get off, I'm gonna say this. In 2008, Gunderson stated that he had tested positive for arsenic and cyanide poisoning. Gunderson's associate, Dr. Edward Lucidi, treated Gunderson and stated that his fingers were turning black, a characteristic symptom of arsenic poisoning. I'm just throwing that out there. We think this is enough for today's episode. Everybody, you all be careful out there. Be safe. Peace, blessings. We'll see you on our next episode, okay?